For Creamer Media's Mining Weekly, I'm Samantha Herbst. With a 98% share of South Africa's mining bulk exports market, Transnet Freight Rail has spent 145 billion rand over the past 5 years to increase the country's rail and port capacity in an attempt to move more bulk freight back to rail. Here to discuss the utility's rail expansion plans is Transnet Freight Rail General Manager of Capital Planning, Brian Monakali. Welcome, Brian.
Thank you, Samantha.
Thank you for joining me. Transnet Freight Rail has several plans underway across the country and intra-regionally to increase port and rail capacity in coal, manganese, and chrome and ferrochrome. Can you elaborate on this and just provide an overview?
Thank you, Samantha. I'm going to start with coal. We are currently in the construction phase for upgrading a line that is from around Pyramid South all the way to Lephalale. It's an existing line which predominantly transport coal. So what we're doing, we're busy upgrading that line from around 2 million tons per annum to in excess of 24 million tons per annum. And the main reason for that is to unlock Waterberg area. As it is known that the future in terms of coal in the country is going to be Waterberg region. The Mpumalanga area is going to flatten going forward in terms of being the main supplier of coal. So as Transnet, we have embarked on a journey together with the miners in Waterberg of developing this rail solution. So the portion that will take us from around 2 million tons to about 12 million tons as we speak now is at construction phase, upgrading the existing 20 ton per axle line. And the portion that's going to take us from around 20 million tons to in excess of 24 million tons is at the feasibility stage. So that's a main program that is in progress as we speak. In parallel to that, we are also busy with a pre-feasibility study for the heavy haul line, because beyond 24 million tons on existing line, we have to do something else. We can't upgrade beyond that. So as a result, we're also kick-starting the pre-feasibility study, which is aimed at constructing a heavy haul line, which will go from the Mpumalanga region all the way to Lephalale, at heavy haul standard, which is 26 tons per axle, which is more like an extension of our existing flagship coal line. At a distance of around 575 kilometers, so that is at pre-feasibility, and we've also started with on a drive to make sure that we don't just do this pre-feasibility study for heavy haul only as Transnet of South Africa. So we are forming a partnership with the Botswana Railways so that we can jointly develop the project, because Botswana has got big deposit of coal. And therefore they need a rail logistics solution. So we're looking at also putting as part of this pre-feasibility study for the heavy haul line to Lephalale, we want to also add onto that the link from Lephalale all the way to Botswana, so that we provide an entire solution that also links the two countries. What that will give you will be an option to also transport coal from Botswana to South Africa, or even for exporting it through Maputo or through Richards Bay through the South African coal network. So that's an expansion plan as far as the coal. In addition to that, there's also a project, I'm sure you must have heard about it. This was the Land Rail Link project. It was recently on the news or on media. So on that project, we're looking at constructing a link between South Africa, which is Mpumalanga area, and Swaziland. It's around 150 kilometers, a new railway line link, which will be constructed at heavy haul standard. So the stage of the project is currently we're seeking funding. It's gone out in the market. There's a team that is working very hard to get the funding. And after getting the funding, it's going to be the construction phase of the link. In addition to the construction of the link, we will also be upgrading the associated network that connects to the link within South Africa and also in Swaziland. So that system will give us a capacity of at least 45 million tons per annum.
So the Swazi Rail Link will divert general freight from the coal line, the current coal line.
That is correct.
Okay, yes. And it will go down to Richards Bay and also to the port of Maputo.
That is correct. So the general freight that is going now through the coal line will be diverted from the coal line, and then you'll go onto this rail link line I'm talking about. Once it goes through the link and then on to Swaziland, there are two options. You can export through Maputo because you already have a link to Maputo, and then obviously you can go down from Golela all the way to Richards Bay for export. So it's going to give you two export options, in terms of the existing ports. So what that does as well for coal is that by moving general freight away from coal, from the existing coal line, you're also relieving capacity for export coal. So in a way, you're also getting that that benefit. Although the main reason for the project, which is the Swaziland Rail Link project, is regional integration, is to link the countries, is to improve the intra-trade between the countries, you know, is to ensure that you can have the cheaper logistics cost within the region. So that's the main objective for that. And the spin-off of that is that you're going to be relieving capacity on the existing coal line for export.
Brian, in terms of manganese, what project is currently underway to expand on export capacity for manganese in South Africa?
Okay, thank you. There's also a project which is in construction phase as we speak, which is looking at upgrading the existing manganese line, which is about around 1,000 kilometers from the Northern Cape to Port Elizabeth. So that project is at construction phase, and the aim is to increase the capacity in the longer term to about 22 million tons per annum. So the project has got various stages, or it's more like a modular in terms of its development, so that as the market improves, you know which capacity, you know, trench or capacity point to activate. So it is in construction as we speak now. It's going to be at heavy haul standard, 26 ton per axle. Once all the work is done, around 208 wagons, dedicated resources, applying all the principles of the heavy haul. So it's going to be another flagship line in terms of the heavy haul developments in the country, in addition to our existing coal and the iron ore line.
So Transnet seems to be working hard at trying to expand capacity for the mining industry, which will benefit the mining industry in the long run. However, as we all know, mining is at a current dip. How does this impact on Transnet's bottom line?
Yeah. Obviously, the funding for the business is dependent on the forecast in terms of the profitability of the company. That's one of the main inputs into the bank or the investor putting the money on the table. That's one of them. So they look at whether you can sustain and be able to pay the money back, to serve the debt. So, and that is mainly based on the forecast. So when the mine is not doing well, so what it means, the demand for the transportation of this of the products goes down, means the profitability of the rail operator also is affected. When that happens, your ability to meet your funding obligations is also challenged, is also compromised. Mm. So which therefore affects now your profitability and the ability to actually sustain the funding. So you get left with no other options but also to slow down in terms of investment. So you slow down, but slowing down with the purpose of ensuring that as the market signals improve, you can just reactivate and move on. So Transnet had to review the capital. I think it was also it was also in the market that there's a review of the capital expenditure to ensure that it's in line with the demand. So it has affected. Hence now we are saying, from the International Heavy Haul Association point of view, where we've got best practice on how to transport bulk freight cheaper, longer trains, heavier trains, best technologies deployed there, for in our case in the country is the coal line and an iron ore line. So we are seeing a big opportunity to utilize, you know, the successes on those heavy haul lines and apply them in the rest of the line, in the rest of the network, in the rest of Africa. You know, because when the market is down, so it's important that the efficiencies, you know, I'm improve more, so as to, you know, to make up for the profitability. So that's where we see this heavy haul principle being applied on existing operations to improve the cost and also safety, and even on the new railway lines that are being that are going to be constructed or are being constructed throughout the countries. How do you ensure that you apply these proven operating principles of the heavy haul lines on the non-heavy haul, so as to even reduce the demand for capital that is required, because you're trying to provide solutions that are cheaper and safer, and therefore lessening the need for a lot of money for investment.
So Transnet's working hard on technological developments to lower the bottom line for both yourselves,
yes,
and for your clients who are
that
the
is correct.
Mining industry.
That is correct. That's one of our main focus. Research is a big area. I mean, we've got the longest production train in the world in the form of the iron ore line for export. It's the longest because, you know, a decision was made years ago to start deployment on technology, like distributed power, that will enable us to run the longer train. So, and we want to apply those principles even on the Chrome General Freight Network, on the Palaborwa network, where you're transporting a magnetite, you know. So we want to apply those principles. You might not go heavier, but going longer using the technology, we see it as one area that's going to give us, you know, the rail solution at the lowest possible cost and safer. Mm.
So, Brian, you are fresh off the plane from Cape Town, from the 11th International Heavy Haul Association Conference. How did it go? That happened last week.
It went very well. I think it exceeded our expectation. It was a great success. And the conference was the best in the history of the International Heavy Haul Association. It's been declared as such. The IAJ has been in existence for 35 years, host conferences every 2 years. This was the best ever. We had in excess of 1,000 people attending the conference. The highest it's ever been is about 720. And the discussion, the topics, and the main thing was more talking about the future. How will the railway of the future look like? We're talking about the fourth industrial revolution, the digital railway, the digital trains. So it was mainly with a main focus in terms of how do we shape our future? Because if we don't, you know, it will be shaped for us by the technological disruptions and so on. So it went very, very well. We had 39 countries that came to the country to attend the conference, representative from 39 countries. And the presenters were coming from 35 countries that were presenting at the conference, from all heavy haul, successful heavy haul countries, China, India, you know, Russia, the US and Canada and so on, South Africa included. So it was really, really great, a great success. And once again, it was not about the event. It was, we're using this conference as a launch pad for making sure that we can progress application of the heavy haul principles, even on non-heavy haul lines throughout Africa. And improve the collaboration in industry to ensure that we can, you know, take ownership of our future and define how should the railways of the future look like.
Something else that happened was you were elected to be chairperson of the International Heavy Haul Association. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All the best in your tenure.
Thank you
very much for joining me, Brian.
Thank you for the invite. I appreciate it.
That was Transnet Freight Rail Executive Brian Monakale chatting to Mining Weekly about the utility's rail expansion plans.